Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be creating this look. Since the festive seasons are going to be starting very soon and we have Navratri coming up, I thought I will create this Navratri look for you. If you like it and if you want to create it, just let's get started very quickly. So first we're going to be starting with the primer. I'm going to be using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Face Primer. This is how it looks. So this primer has a very small amount of sparkly particles in it. So this is how the primer looks. I'm just going to apply it all over my face and rub it out with my hands. You can also use your beauty blender, but I prefer using rubbing out my primer with my hands. Once you're done with the primer, next we'll move on to the foundation. I'm going to be using the matte Fit Me Poreless Foundation by Maybelline. This is my favorite, absolute favorite. I literally use this in all of my videos. And along with that, I'm going to be using the Maybelline Strobing Cream. So what you want to do is you're going to just take your regular quantity of your foundation on the back of your hand. And if you have taken two pumps, just take one pump of the strobing cream. So it's going to be always a 2:1 ratio. So that's how it looks, the foundation and the strobing cream. And I'm just going to blend it out with my finger. Not blend it, I'm going to just mix it out with my fingers. So that's how I mix it. And you can use a brush for this, but I'm going to be using my fingers to just dab the product all over my face in tiny dots so that I can just blend it out easily with my beauty blender. So I'm going to take the remaining product onto my neck. Weird way to take it, but yeah, it was just stuck over there, so I'm going to just take it that way. Take a wet beauty blender. This one is by Nykaa or Shein. I think this one is by Nykaa, I'm not sure. But yeah, so I'm just going to take it, wet it. Always use a damp beauty blender to blend your foundation it, because it moves in and sits very beautifully after that. So just gotta rub it, push it into my skin. And remember always to cover your neck as well if you're gonna be wearing an open neck outfit, so that your face and the neck looks similar colored. And once you're happy with your blending, you can just leave it that way and move on. If you want, also if you feel like the foundation is not enough, you can take some more and just, you know, blend out on the face. But I think I'm happy with it. I don't like a very heavily concealed and foundation base. I like to show, keep it a bit dewy and natural. So next I'm going to move on to the concealer. I'm going to be using the Fit Me concealer again. Again, this is not like a Maybelline product review, but you're going to be seeing a lot of Maybelline products in this video because I'm a Maybelline girl. I'm going to be using two of them. You will see why. So first I'm going to take the shade 15. This is called 15 Fair. And I love this concealer, okay? Most of the time when I go to office, I don't even have any foundation on. What I do is I just apply my moisturizer and apply my concealer in these inverted triangles in the areas that I feel need a bit conceal in and which are dark. I dab it out and that's it. That's my go-to everyday makeup look, like literally. I don't use foundation on a daily basis. Like a lot of people who know me, they feel I use a lot of makeup every day, but no, that's just my skin, okay? So next I'm going to just take the same damp beauty blender and blend it out. So you're going to be seeing a lot of weird faces, okay, expressions. So just don't be scared by it. But always look on top and then blend out your concealer because it just gives better coverage. So I've just finished with my concealing and I'm going to be highlighting my face now. For that, I'm going to be using the same Fit Me foundation. The same Fit Me concealer, but this is in the shade 10 Light. So always remember, whenever you're concealing, use a shade which is similar to your skin tone. But if you want to highlight it, always go one shade lighter to your skin. Okay, so yeah, just going to do that. Just going over the same. So I just like to highlight my under eye area because the work stress, you know, these days just causes so much of dark circles. And I'm going to go on the bridge of my nose and on my chin. Basically the same areas that I concealed. But this is just going to be giving a nice highlighting look. ठीक है, एंड वी आर डन विद द कंसीलर. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज वी नीड टू सेट ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स दैट वी यूज, बिकॉज मुंबई इज लाइक सुपर हॉट राइट नाउ एंड आई एम गोइंग टू बी स्वेटिंग वेरी सून. सो टू प्रिवेंट दैट आई एम गोइंग टू बी यूजिंग द फिट मी. येस अगेन इट्स गोइंग टू बी फिट मी, द फिट मी कंसीलिंग पाउडर. दिस इज द लूज फिनिशिंग पाउडर, एक्चुअली नॉट कंसीलिंग पाउडर, इट्स अ लूज फिनिशिंग पाउडर एंड इट कम्स इन दिस, इट्स लाइक दिस. आई मीन आई डोंट नो इफ यू कैन लुक, but I'm just scared it's gonna fall. So I'm gonna take a fluffy brush. You can also take your beauty blender, but I just like using the brush. So yes, just take that, take enough powder on it and dab it on your eyes and basically any area that you want to set. So just gonna set my neck as well. Yeah. And I tend to sweat a lot around my mouth, so need a little bit of more concealing out there. Why do I keep saying concealing, setting? And we are done. Next, we're going to be doing our eyebrows. I'm going to be using the Revolution Focus and Fix. You cannot see the name of it because it's like completely gone. This is the name of the product. I'll put all the links in the description. So this one comes with 4 shades. I'm going to be using this lightest brown over here and the darkest brown out here. It also has a gel which you can use for setting. So you always put the lightest shade on your, if you have a palette, eyebrow palette, and you will always have like a light shade and a dark shade. The light shade always goes on the inner corners and the dark shade goes on the outers. I think I have made a video on that as well, so I'll link it somewhere out here. You can go and check out how I do my eyebrows and like the whole detailed eyebrow process. And we are done with the eyebrow. I think I'm happy with how it looks. Do you think it looks nice? I'm just gonna go and do my other eyebrow and come back soon to you. So next we're gonna be doing our eyes. For my eyes, I'm gonna be using the Makeup Revolution palette. It's a Flawless 4 palette and this is how it looks. It comes in a beautiful package and this has 32 shades, I believe. Yes, 32 shades. And just look at how versatile and pretty the palette is. Just like, it has pinks, it has some smoky colors, it has the glitters. I love this palette. So first I'm going to be taking this brown shade. It's like a nice coffee brown color and I'm taking a fluffy brush. This brush, I think I picked this set. Just look at it first of all. A minute to admire it. It's like mermaid and yeah, I got it from Shein, I believe. So yeah, I'm just going to take that brush. It's a blending brush and I'm just going to apply it on my crease so that when you apply the other colors, it looks very natural and it just like blends out really well. I'm just going to blend it out with a very light hand and using this wiper motion. And yeah, that next I'll be taking a flat brush and I will be picking up this color right here. And I'm just going to apply it all over my eyelid so that whatever color I apply next just pops out a bit. You can also apply your concealer all over your eyelid and then go with the color because that also gives a very nice look. Taking the same brush and just blending everything in. So I'm thinking I'll do a nice pink smoky eye. So I'm taking this pink shade right here. I'm going to apply it all over my crease firstly and then we'll go with some other color for the outer eye. That's it. And next I'm going to be taking this dark pinkish plum color and I'm going to be applying it on the outer corner of the eye. For that I'm using the same blending brush that I used previously with the brown. Tap off the extra color and just apply it in a V shape. Okay, taking my other blending brush and just gonna blend out all the colors with a very light hand. And that's it for now. I think I'll put a little bit of shimmer because it's a Navratri video. So I'm gonna be taking this rose gold glimmery shade over here. So a tip, whenever you're applying glitter colors, always take a fixing brush, fixing spray and put it on your brush. If you don't have a fixing spray, just make your brush a little damp. That enables the color to stick on easily. Can you see that? It looks so pretty. I love this color. So yeah, it just helps the lit color to stick. So I'm just going to press it and I'm not going to be blending out anything out here. And then go with your blending brush once again and just give a light blend. And that's it. How does it look? Does it look pretty? Next, I'm going to be taking a pencil brush like so. And I'm going to be taking the same light pink color that I took for my eyelid. And I'm going to be applying it on my waterline. And if you have any fallouts, don't worry about it. We are going to be cleaning it up later. And then I'm going to take the dark plum color and apply it on the outer corners of my waterline. And yes, that's it. I'm just going to go and do my other eye and I'm going to be back. And once we are done with the eye, just take the same fluffy brush that you used with your powder and just tap out whatever excess color that you can see under the eye. Next, we are going to be going with our eyeliner. For my eyeliner, you can use a black eyeliner, but I'm going to be using a brown one because I like the soft look that it gives rather than black looking very harsh. So I'm going to be using the K-Beauty eyeliner and this is in the shade Grunge Raisin. This is how the product looks. It's a beautiful eyeliner and it comes with this very fine, subtle, applicator. Should I do a winged eyeliner? Should I? I think I will. Let's see. I also have a video on how you can do your eyeliner. I'm going to be linking that as well. Go watch it if you haven't seen it already. So that's how I have just done a very subtle, it's not so subtle, but it's a wing and yeah, not very bright. So once you're done with the eyeliner, you can totally skip this part if you don't want it. I'll be lining my waterline with a brown kajal. This is by Rimmel. It's called Exaggerate and it has this nice smoky eye look sponge on the other end, but I'm not going to be smoking it out today. You can also do this with any dark brown eyeshadow if you don't have a brown kajal or whatever. You can just use either an eyeshadow or a kajal for this. So I'm just going to line this part. I generally don't do this with any western looks, but I think traditional looks call for kajal. So once you've applied your kajal, you can just take your fingers and smudge it out. I think I will smudge it out after all, just to give it a nice smoky look. So this is how it looks. It has this sponge on the other end, so just lightly gonna smoke it and smudge it. Next, I'm gonna be doing my lashes. I'm using the L'Oreal False Lash Superstar. I love this mascara. So for me, generally, if I like a beauty product, I will stick to it and I'll keep rebuying it. So yeah, this is just one of those. So this comes with two ends. The first side has a number one and number two end. The number one just has this white brush and particles in it, which enlarges your eyelashes. So I'm just going to apply that first. Weird face is coming back again. I look like the Snow Queen from Narnia right now, like, don't I? I'm going to apply some on the lower lash line too. And see, that's how it looks. Next, I'm going to be taking the other side. This is like a normal mascara on the other side. But I like the brush because it's like a little bent and it gives a nice control. And whoa, it's like falsies, okay? It's like you're wearing falsies. For all you girls who don't like using falsies, or if you're like me and don't know how to use falsies, this is perfect. So I tried using falsies, but too much hassle. This mascara has just spoiled me. Yes, we are done. Yes, and we are done with our makeup. Just kidding, we still have our blush and lipstick to go. First, we'll go with the blush. I have two blushes out here. One is the Nykaa Get Cheeky Blush Duo. This is in the color Malibu Barbie. It's one of my absolute favorite blushes. It has two colors out here. And the other one that I have is the Maybelline Master Flush Creator. This is in the shade what is the shade? It's called Kiss Bite and this comes in this ombre kind of color. So I think I will go with the Nykaa one and just use any blush brush. This one is by Wet n Wild and I'm going to be using the... Actually, I'm just going to mix both of them. So I'm just going to take this color and this color. I'm just going to mix them together. And ready to smile. Smile, smile and apply the blush. Like, can you see it on the camera? It's such a beautiful pink color. It makes you look so healthy. It gives a very healthy, flush on your cheeks without looking too fake. So yeah, that's it with the blush. I think I'm happy with it. Next, we're going to be applying the highlighter. For my highlighter, I'm using the NYX Love You So Mochi. And it's so pretty. It comes with three highlighter shades. You have a pink, you have a gold, and then you have this champagne color. So I, as you can see, I just swatched them for you actually. 1 minute. Like, they are beautiful. And they are so soft, like so soft. Like, very pretty. So since this is like, I'm going to be wearing a yellow outfit, I think I'll go with the golden color. I'm taking a fan brush and just going to swirl my brush on it and go crazy with the highlighter. If it's looking too much right now, don't worry, because we're going to be blending all of it out. So I'm just going to apply a little more. Don't worry, it's fine. It's all fine. You can never have too much highlighter, right? I'm just going to apply it on the bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow, above my, wherever, all of my high points basically. And yes, that's it. So if you are in a situation like mine where you feel you are glowing too much, just take the powder brush and I'm just going to dab everything with it. I always recommend this step. Take your beauty blender, the one which you use to apply your foundation, and just dab it all out, okay? So that everything looks very natural and it looks very put together. Yeah. And that's it. We are done. And I'm just going to use a fixing spray. I recommend using the fixing spray before you do your mascara because it tends to bleed out. So yeah, I don't know if it's going to blend out, bleed out now. So I'm just going to take a quick shower in it. Oh, and the one which I'm using is the NYX Dewy Finish finishing spray. This is how it looks like. Just going to take my beauty blender once again and press everything in. And that's it. It brings us to the final step, which is my favorite. It's the lipstick. I'm going to be using the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink. You can go with, if you're going with this exact look, you can go with any pink shade. Don't go with a red. Use any pink plums or like a burnt plum, burnt purple color. That would look perfect. If you want to go with a red, try and switch the pink that you're using with some golden colors or with some orangey colors, and that would look perfect. So this is how the brush looks. It's super matte, okay? It's like amazing. And that's it. It brings us to the end of our makeup look. And now time to get glammed up and accessorize and come back right here to see the final look. Hope all of you like this video. I enjoyed creating this look for all of you, and truly doesn't take a lot of time. You just need to follow all of the steps and you will have this pretty look. Just accessorize well and wear a pretty outfit and you are done to go and rock your Navratri. So yes, if you like my video, don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Also do comment in the comment section below about how you liked my video, if there are any things that I can change, or if there are any specific looks that you want me to create. So that's it for today. I'm going to be back very soon and there are going to be a lot of festive videos coming up on my channel. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button so that you can get notified on all my videos that are going to be coming up for you. And I'll see you again very soon in my next video. Bye. Toodles.